Welcome! This is Dr. Plague, and today we're going to continue with part two of CNC machining a plaque. We'll be taking the output files that we created in part one to the CNC machine and see how this turns out. You'll get to see the CNC machine in action. This you are not going to want to miss, so stick around. This is the CNC machine we'll be using. It is a Sainsmart Genmitsu 3018 Pro with a maximum spindle speed of 7,000 RPM. It's small, but versatile. For the 1/8-inch router bits, I'll be using these spiral cut bits which I got from Harbor Freight. They are too long, so to get them to fit, I use this cutoff saw to shorten them. I'll use this bit to route the outside edge. I also bought this pack of router bits from Sainsmart, and I'll use the 1.6mm bit out of this pack. I'll use this bit to route the text. I 3D printed these cage nuts for attaching the hold down hardware to the bed of the CNC machine. This is the offline controller. It's basically useless and has trouble with some of the G-code, so I recommend to not use it. Instead, I'll use a computer on the other side of this board. The board will shield the computer from all the sawdust. I'll now install the 1/8-inch bit and tighten it with a couple of wrenches. I'll start candle and load up the outline NC file. I'm going to move the router bit to the starting position. I am using 3/4-inch thick wood to make the plaque and have attached it with the mounting bolts. I'm going to lower the bit gradually until it grabs this piece of paper. Add whatever it is. Then I'll zero out the coordinates in candle. Very important that you do this. Now I start sending the G-code to the CNC machine. And here we go. Notice that I am using a dust blower used for cleaning a camera lens. It seems to work quite well to blow the dust out of the way so we can get a better view of the progress. One thing to note about this CNC machine is that by default, when you set the spindle speed, it is not in RPM as you would expect. A speed of 1,000 indicates 100% speed, and for this spindle operating at 24 volts, it is 7,000 RPM. There are many people that seem not to understand this, so I thought I would mention it. The speed controls the voltage, so be aware it might not be linear to RPM. And the outline is done after about 1 hour and 43 minutes. I blew the dust out of it using an air compressor and will take a measurement of how deep the routed cut is. It is about 1/2 inch, as I would expect. Perfect. I am going to take the piece off the bed to clean it up a bit and get rid of any tear out. First, I'll use a wood marking punch to make sure I don't sand away the starting position. Then, we'll send this through the drum sander. Beautiful. Now, we'll reinstall it on the CNC bed. Let's load the NC file for the text and move the router bit to the starting position. Notice that I have replaced the 1/8 inch bit with a 1.6 millimeter bit. Again, I'll make sure the bit grabs a sheet of paper to adjust the height. We'll zero it out and start sending the G-code to the machine. And here it goes. You can notice that the computer turns the finished areas to gray. Each letter gets routed out separately, and I think it looks quite nice. Please leave a comment on what you think. Kind of fun to watch, isn't it? Wow, that took about 2.5 hours. So, that's the end of part 2 on CNC machining a plaque. This is the first plaque that I have made on a CNC machine. I'm excited to see how it turns out, so please join us next time for the final installment. Please leave any comments or questions below, and I'll try to answer as many as I can. So, if you like this video, be sure to peck at that like button. And don't forget to subscribe and peck at that notification bell to be notified of all my new videos as they become available. Thank you, and we'll see you next time, right here on Dr. Plaque.